I am Nathan McNeil, bringing you from the international studios of McNeil, Mark McNeil.
Here we are. We're going to talk about perfect price discrimination. Well, what's the definition of price discrimination? The definition of price discrimination is charging different prices to different customers for the same item, and there's a caveat. What is it? That the price differences may not be justified by cost differences. Now, not just anybody can price discriminate, you know. There are conditions necessary. One is the firm, the seller, has to have some market power. They can't just be a price taker. Second is, they must identify and segregate different groups or different individuals according to their elasticity of demand. The people with the most inelastic demand will be charged the highest or the lowest price?
It will be the highest.
That's right. And the people whose demand is most elastic will be charged?
The lowest.
The lowest.
That's right. And the third is, they must be able, there must be some method to prevent resale. If you can't prevent resale, what happens is the elastic types buy it at the low price and then sell it to the inelastic types at a price less than you would sell it to them for. And so it won't work unless you can prevent resale. Now there is a fourth thing, and that is you have to learn to tell a good story that explains your behavior. Otherwise people will yell at you and DAs will come after you. Alright, so here's the deal. This demand curve says there's a price at which nobody wants to buy it. The maximum that one person is willing to pay for it is that price, and then somebody else would if they had to pay that price, and that price, and that price, etc. So every point on a demand curve tells you the maximum that somebody's willing to pay for it. Right there, that person is willing to pay zero for it. And if you want to get rid of that many units, you have to pay them. Anyway, that's what a demand curve talks about. So let's compare one price before I show you the price discrimination. If this is a price searcher and they're going to charge one price to everyone, then this would be the marginal revenue. Remember, it has twice the slope of the demand curve here. And they would produce this quantity, Q1, where marginal revenue equals marginal cost, and they would charge price P1. And their total revenue would be price times quantity, so it would be this red rectangle here. But if they're able to price discriminate perfectly, they would charge each person the maximum they're willing to pay. And so this first person, if this is the maximum they're willing to pay, they would sell it to them for that, and they would collect that much revenue from them. Say this is $90. And then there's the $89 person, and the $88, and the $87, and the $86, etc. And they would continue to sell as long as the price was greater than the marginal cost, because to a price discriminator that is able to price discriminate perfectly, price is equal to marginal revenue. Price and marginal revenue are the same, which means that this demand curve shows you also marginal revenue. And the reason is that marginal revenue is equal to price minus the givebacks. But so when you sell at one price, when you lower the price to one person, you have to lower it for all these other people. So there are givebacks. But with perfect price discrimination, you don't have to lower the price to previous people in order to sell the additional unit to the person who will only pay the lower price. So in this case, this seller would sell Q sub PD here for price discrimination. That's the quantity they would sell. And look at the revenue. They would collect this amount of revenue. So obviously, price discrimination increases both revenues and profits if they can do it. And from society's point of view, we will revisit our old friends here. This triangle is consumer surplus. This area here is producer surplus. Here is opportunity cost. But look at this rectangle here. That represents lost wealth because the correct number of units are not being produced and sold. This is dead weight loss. But in this example, with perfect price discrimination, this red rectangle represents producer surplus, and this lower area represents opportunity cost. And where is consumer surplus? It's in this seller's pocket. Now, is this good or bad? Depends on your perspective, I suppose. In fact, with perfect price discrimination, this area of consumer surplus is lost, but also this area of deadweight loss doesn't exist either. So, the correct number of units are produced, and all of this wealth that would have been lost between producers and consumers exists in this circumstance with perfect price discrimination. So, that's it. Perfect price discrimination, they charge everybody the highest price they're willing to pay. Marginal revenue is the same as demand. They'll produce until the demand, that is the marginal revenue, is equal to the marginal cost here. And it greatly increases producer surplus, but consumer surplus is gone. Say goodbye.